Hello friends, welcome to Programming Concepts. My name is Amit and this is part 5 of ASP.NET Core MVC tutorial. In this video, we will talk about the main method in ASP.NET Core MVC application. This is continuation to part 4, ASP.NET Core project file. So please watch it before proceeding to this one. I shared the link in the description. And here is the project which we are working with. In the Solution Explorer, you can see Program.cs file. Click on it. So within Program.cs file, there is a static void main method. If you have any prior experience in .NET, you must be aware that main method was only associated with console application. But here, we are developing MVC web application. So the obvious question is, why main method? Answer to this question is, ASP.NET Core initially starts as a console application, and main method is the entry point of this application. So if I comment on line within main method, so there is only one line, let's comment that. And let's say write console.WriteLine hello world. And instead of IS Express from top, let's pick the project file and run. And you can see the output hello world here. So press any key to exit. So it is nothing but a console application. Let's uncomment the line and delete our code. So now it's clear that all magic to convert console to web application is written within CreateHostBuilder method. Now if you see CreateHostBuilder is returning iHostBuilder. In .NET Core, host is created by application itself. So the next question is, what is host? So let me take you to the Microsoft website. And here is the Microsoft website. So let's read the definition first. A host is an object that encapsulates an app resources, such as dependency injection, logging, configuration, and iHosted services implementation. So the definition might not make any sense at the moment. Just think of host as something which defines the outside boundary for your application, which is responsible to make things available for your application. To begin with, just think .NET host as a party host. So whenever you host any event, you are responsible for organizing almost everything, correct? So in the event, if you decided to select only vanilla ice cream to be served from the available packages you have, and you don't opt for chocolate ice cream, then all your guests can only have option to have vanilla ice cream. Similarly, in .NET Core, if your host decided that I will only select MVC services, and he also decided that he will not opt for MVC Core services, then your application can only use MVC services and not the MVC Core services. Simple? Extremely simple. Just think of host in that way. We will cover each and everything in the later video session. Another important thing is that in a web app, one of the iHosted service implementation is a web service that starts an HTTP server implementation. So what is that HTTP server implementation? So just click on it. So an ASP.NET Core app uses an HTTP server implementation to listen for HTTP request. So whenever user hits on a browser, HTTP request has been generated. So there are different kinds of implementation available in .NET Core. And here they are. So within the different kind of implementation, first one is Kestrel, which is a real magic behind .NET Core application. So Kestrel is a cross-platform web server. Kestrel is often run in a reverse proxy configuration using IIS, but with ASP.NET Core 2.0 or later, Kestrel can be run as a public-facing edge server, which is a really big statement. Means you don't need IIS, you don't need Apache, you don't need Tomcat. Kestrel itself is capable to take HTTP request. So we'll talk about them in our later video session. So this is one of the implementation. So other implementation will be IIS HTTP server is a server for Windows that uses IIS. With this server, ASP.NET Core app and IIS run in the same process. Third one is http.sys is a server for Windows that isn't used with IIS. We'll talk about each one of them in our later video session. So this is the kind of implementation which is available in .NET Core. All right, let's get back to Visual Studio and see the implementation of CreateHostBuilder method. So first thing is host. So let's go to its definition by pressing F12. So you can see this is nothing but static class provided by Microsoft to configure default builder setting. It has two methods, CreateDefaultBuilder with and without arguments. So what these methods are doing? So in the summary, you can see it initializes a new instance of HostBuilder class with pre-configured defaults and return iHostBuilder. So for now, just understand this method loads some default settings for your host. So the default settings are like setting the content root path, loading the configuration from environment variables and command line arguments, loading the app configuration from app setting.json, user secrets, environment variables, command line arguments, etc. And it also enables scope validation and dependency validation when the environment is in development. So these are the different default settings which has been set here. Nothing specific. We'll talk about them maybe in our upcoming video sessions. So create default builder method loads and configure the different setting. Then it calls the configure web host defaults. Let's go to its definition. So this is present under Microsoft.extension.hosting namespace. And as you can see in the definition, this keyword has been used. So this is generally for extension method, and configure web host default is nothing but an extension method. So if you look at the summary, this extension method is also configures your host with default setting for hosting a web app. All right, so let's go to its remark section. So within remark, you can see that following defaults has been applied to your host. And the first one is really important. Use Kestrel as a web server and configure it using the application's configuration provider. So we have just discussed it that there are different server implementations. So when we used that particular extension method, we are using Kestrel as a web server. And there are a few other defaults as well. I don't think that it's too early to cover all these defaults for now. So just for now, just think that this method also create some default setting for your host. That's it. Let's get back to program.cs file. So next is use startup method, which accept a .cs file. So let's go to start.cs file. So in this file, first method is configure services. This method gets called by the runtime. Use this method to add services to the container. So this is a place where we actually add our services. This is where the concept of dependency injection will come. Second method is configure. This method is used to configure the HTTP request pipeline, and this is also known as the middleware. So these two are very important methods. We'll talk about them in our upcoming videos. Don't worry about it. So at runtime, our host uses this to call to set up dependency injection and the middleware pipeline. All right. And from here, we are getting our message on the UI. So let's place some breakpoints in startup.cs file, next on program.cs to see how the process will work. Let's create two more debugger in our application. One after create host builder method within main method at line number 17, and another one within create host builder method. In that note, let's select IIS Express from top and let's run our application. So as expected, because main is our main entry point, so it came within main method. It was as expected. So when I press on continue or when I press on F5, so just click on that and it should go to create host builder method as expected, and that's how it works. When I press continue, it goes to startup.cs file And the first method is configure services. So here we can configure our services, our dependencies. Let's press continue. So it goes to configure method where we can configure the HTTP request pipeline. All right. So then it will go to ideally to this line, then it will print hello world to you. But if I press F5, then ideally it should go to line number 17, correct? Because I already placed a debugger there. So let's see whether the debugger goes to line number 17 or not. So let me press continue. So it print hello world, but it doesn't go to line number 17. So this is a homework for you. If you had learned the host builder and whole concept of host correctly, then you might be able to understand why this debugger don't go to line number 17. So that's the homework for you, and that's it from this video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.